As we just said it, Gary. Let's get it started. Melbourne and the Dogs at the MCG on a Sunday. Bartram had a little push in there, but I think a free kick's going straight to the superstar, Scotty West. Didn't see the infringement, but he's got the first of what promises to be many possessions. Long ball in the Johnson direction. Bruce with him. Bruce got a hand in there. Carroll. Whelan. Brown. And wide to Ward, who had a bit of a glimpse of Brock McLean, footy over the line.
Robertson in the square with Lindsay Gilbey as his opponent. Holland has started for. David Neitz playing up the ground at the moment. Harris on Davey. Morris.
White. McDonald. And now McLean. How important is he to the Demons outfit? I would suggest very, very important. Bartram had a great year, this young man. And playing like an experienced campaigner out there this year. Has got a lot of composure about him. His skills weren't great there as he gave it to West. Kick wasn't very good either. Perhaps an infringing Rowan Smith there. We'll see Bartram win the ball back and see whether he can make amends.
Well, now start the game. Really lacklustre at the minute.
Breeze. As you can see, quite strong at ground level, blowing Bartram's hair around. There's Sylvia. I think he's got that much product in there. His hair can't move. The young man. Lots of talent in this package as well. Just dumps it long and wide. So there's... I go to Chris Jones. It looks like it's swirling down at ground level, Jonesy.
Yeah, it really has. It's picked up in probably the last 15 minutes or so. It's just blowing towards the Demons' end.
Okay. Harris... high and long. A double demon fist. Sylvia. Ward with some room to move. For the speeds to Davey. Oh, Neitz. Beautiful delivery. He had Harris all day long.
This is a hard ground to defend. If you move the footy quickly, there is ample space for big forwards to lead into.
This man has got some range, Brian. Early in the game especially.
Indeed.
From downtown for the Demons first. Oh, jeez, he's just done it. Goal post high. And I reckon it's through. Demons get the first.
And if you think David Neitz looks happy about that, you'd be right. It's his first goal in 3 weeks, boys. He's had a little bit of a lean trot. Loves this ground. Always plays well on this ground. And look, this is just what... it produces when you move the ball quickly. There's plenty of room and space to move into, and the best defenders in the competition are going to find that hard to stop, and that will work both ends of the ground. That's why I'm staggered to see that first couple of minutes of the play stuck over on the outer wing and Sylvia kicks on the full.
Good start by the Demons, and especially David Neitz. First goal in 3 weeks has set the Demons up for a good first quarter straight. West has had three touches of the ball already. McLean out wide. Here's McMahon, the speedster, the genuine speedster with the Dogs outfit. Missed it. Neitz around the body. Opportunity. Sylvia missed. Now Cooney, she's got to tidy up. Harris under some pressure. Might have been White, in fact. It was. The short kick is good to cross. The linking play through the middle. Griffin loves to be in this place. Position Ryan Griffin.
Oh,
almost run down, as he does every week. Aaron Davey, someone from behind. Now Morris. Johnson on the lead in front of Bruce. Great mark.
That's a super mark, isn't it? We marvelled at this man last week against Geelong. They really struggled to find a matchup for him, and the Demons have pumped with Cameron Bruce there. Most versatile player.
Now the Bulldogs elected a kick to this particular end of the ground, and the wind apparently pushing the other way, so let's see whether the stand is sheltering it. It is. That's gone through, no problems at all for Brad Johnson, and the Dogs get there first.
Boy, the midfield is so critical at the MCG. It's why Scott West is going to be such a pivotal player. You've already mentioned he's racked up three possessions. Simon Godfrey, the man, has got the job. What about the year he's having, West? Number one in the competition for disposals, handballs, hardball gets, contested possessions, and number one for frees. He's just having an amazing year, so they need to shut him down, because once the delivery gets to that standard, Blokes like Johnson will dine out on it.
Go down to Chris Jones.
Chris Grant straight onto the ground, 4 minutes in into full forward.
Big fist from White to centre half forward. Robertson had to stick his head over it and try and get it banging his club's way. West again with commitment. McDonald was terrific. Godfrey the long left football. Holland down there, one out, it carries him. It'll bounce through.
That's a nice way to put the onus back on Scott West. Push forward and kick a goal. And it did carry the pack pretty well, so not sure what the breeze is doing out there. I mean, this ground is so enclosed now, I guess it will swirl around a little bit, but it's a nice start for Well, that's a very important possession for Simon Godfrey. Someone like Scott West has got to be made aware of his opponent. Has to, can't be allowed to play purely on his own terms.
Now the Demons from long range get their second, and it's pretty straight kicking as we see it at the moment, and a very attacking game of football. Stay tuned, this sort of footy gets us all very enthusiastic. West with yet another possession, he is on fire. Eagleton outmanoeuvring was Rivers on this occasion.
Now three times these teams have played, Brian, they've averaged a combined total of 33 goals. So you're right, they will have shootouts.
Bate with the handball, and the delivery downfield is great to Sylvia. The little low ball to Nathan Brown. I'm not sure it was deliberate. I thought it was for Uze. Doesn't matter. Play on now. McLean driving ball. Holland one out. The punch attempt. Now the help from Harris. Holland still alive though. Hanging off the back of him, White. Uze needed clean hands. Quick decision. Got it. In game 250.
Well, there's a good start for Melbourne. And Ben Holland just, that is the role that he needs to play. I wouldn't let him get outside that square. Just contest the footy. Your man Lindsay Gilbey there just got lost in traffic, Brian. And someone as talented as Adam Uze only needs a little bit of room to make something happen.
Well, there's the flags on top of the big stand. Not a lot of movement there, but a swirling wind at ground level. 3-1. Exciting start. Griffin wrapped up in a McDonald tackle. Here's West again. Just getting a poultice of it. Farron Ray. Into the centre and Jordan McMahon. Beautiful kick as a rule. No exception. I think Smith may have got in his teammate Bear's way on that occasion. And a locked up footy.
Davis Johnston onto the ground, gone straight in the middle. Now Brock McLean, the player that came off for a spell.
Peter Street giving away a free kick. Jeff White, the recipient. Numbers out wide, including Matthew Whelan. Bate. Over the top, he was a bit fierce for Whelan. And the Dogs are happy to see it over. That was Robbins.
Yes, Bate and then Sylvia it was earlier in this game. Put one out in the full.
Jeff White having a spell. J-Mark comes sprinting back onto the ground. That allowed Street to get the knockout because J-Mark hadn't reached the contest. Davey. And Morris. Morris closing him down now. Applying the pressure. It was really well done by Morris. He didn't go at him too quickly. He just corralled him and waited for his opportunity to cut the corner.
Just sensational from Dale Morris. Yeah. Leg speed, I mean, he'd be one of the few in the comp could stay with Aaron Davey.
Smith West, yet again, setting up to McMahon, who has a very dangerous left foot. Kick into cross. Cross is marked within range, but only just. He's not a long kick of the ball. But he's directly in front.
Scott West up to six possessions. Just getting his hands on the footy at those stoppages and clearances. So critical. Now, this hasn't been a strong part of Daniel Cross's game. He likes, much prefers the handball. But he's just got to kick this goal.
This is the part that he can add to his game, Gary, if he can tidy this up a bit. Cross. Daniel comes in. Good looking ball. Dogs have got their second.
Well, we are on, what is it, 3-2 here. We're in for a very entertaining afternoon if the style of game continues in this manner. Troy footy play at this ground is the best going around. Better standard, produces better footy, and that is a nice finish from Daniel Cross. That's the area that he needs to work on. He's making a pretty fair fist of it.
Three goals, plays two. Damar now in the centre. On a work of clearance, Melbourne's way. Umpires again, allowing a long time for a decision, and then the decision's going to go the Demons' way.
Chris Grant's gone back and he's playing loose in Melbourne's forward line. That's the first sign of a defensive move.
Bait. Long range with the left foot. Needs to come in from the side. Got the hands to it, but couldn't take it. At ground level, Robertson. Had a bit of a dip. Very nicely done by the Dog defence, including the champion Chris Grant. That's a beautiful kick. Cross can take it and go. Baird tucked hard against the line, and I think he might get a free for a push.
He does. Now he's got Griffin on. Griffin time to deliver to Smith. Smith will be manned up and made the kick over the mark. Now on the lead here is Johnson. He's got free of his man, Bruce. He turned him around in the goal square. Bruce did well to recover, though. Kick wasn't what it should have been from Smith. Eagleton. So the Dogs applying a bit of pressure now. Where's Eagleton going? McMahon, another left footer. Smith on the run is capable of goaling from here. Long ball to the square. Robbins behind. And Cameron Bruce safe.
Love to see defenders back themselves, Gary, and get the Jukes involved.
It's going to be a great contest. Nathan Jones, the first gamer, on as well.
Ward over the top. Nathan Brown, lots of Nathans in this Melbourne team. Handball off to Travis Johnston. Not a great kick forward from him. He'll be in good position. Harris, just the one hand to it. Oh, Davey was magnificent. Look at him go. Just stretches past Gilby and kicks a magnificent goal.
Not too many players in the competition you'd enjoy watching more than Aaron Davey, I don't reckon. He just made something out of nothing. It was a horrible kick from Travis Johnston. Bounced in between three players. Leitch was one out. August, look at that. From there, a goal is created just because of this bloke's ability to run and carry. I mean, that shouldn't happen. There's four Western Bulldog blokes around him, and he can go away and do that.
The Demons playing some exciting footy early. Davey, the fourth goal for the Demons. Straight West again. Morris just keeps supplying the ball to his midfielders. West, Minton, did it on Ward. Surely a free, didn't dispose of it.
Big Will went back for seconds and gave the free kick away.
Oh.
Yes.
Ward just having a bit of a chat with him about the details of that exchange.
He's got to control the aggression, Big Will.
Daniel Ward. Now Whelan. They mount a challenge down the southern stand side of the ground here at the MCG. Ward can run forward and does. Uncontested. Hargrave in a position to mark. Was in two minds. Uze. Snap missed. Minor score.
Had to see one of them eventually. Six straight goals in the match. The Dogs from the fullback area. Ray. The half forward Baird's got lots of room. To Robbins. That is coast to coast.
It is. If that's the indication of what happens, Melbourne better not score any more behinds, because that was ridiculously easy. I think Matthew Whelan lost. Baird the player, did he come off the end? He's been on the whole game, I think. Godfrey comes for a spell. And Scott West has given him a hard first 10 minutes.
Robbins with the set shot. It looks good. Excellent stuff from Robbins.
Beautiful finish from Matty Robbins. Beautiful kicking. Some lovely skills on display here. Now Godfrey's off, who had been on West. West had seven possessions. James McDonald was the player that came back on, who's also had four possessions himself, four handballs. So, sure whether they'll go head to head.
It's game on at the MCG. We have had seven goals kicked in 15 minutes of football here. Fast, free-flowing game of attacking footy. Great to watch. Jamar McDonald has just come onto the ground, giving Godfrey a rest. Nathan Brown. Smith tries to track him down. Now Brock McLean. Under pressure, delivering the ball forward. Uze nudges on the ball. Gilby. Now Hargrave. Boyd. He also is a fresh man on the ground. The kick to Grant, couldn't run on.
That's the loose player, but they've done well to hold the loose man up. You know, they love to carry and run. They've done well here.
Kearney and Boyd combining now. Boyd goes backwards to Morris. He tidies it up. It was a nice piece of play, and the delivery a little short across. Quick hands was great. Advantage paid as Kearney inside the centre square. Long ball to the square. Johnson slipped over. And Brad Johnson saying, what are you doing? Dave's arms are waving there, and a boundary throw in deep for the Dogs.
Sensational season again for Brad Johnson. There's Chris Grant. Elvin players want holding. Umpires again letting it go, but now there'll be a bounce. Rivers and Baird pick themselves up. Scotty West earning a break. Seven possessions already for him. Peter Street sitting it out as well. Minson to the back. Couldn't get boot to ball. Rivers. McDonald did it well to Whelan. Bartram. Down the line. Sylvia. Got hands to it. Couldn't take it. Look away handball. This will be Jones's first touch. Got a bit of Glenn Lovett about him. Bit of the eagle, Gary. They'll be delighted, the D's, if they get the same service out of this young man, as the handball's good to Ward in the end. Long ball in the Davey direction. Gilby, he's got to beat, and he does it. That's some nice body work from the light frame of Davey.
We may have to look at that matchup. He's just run away from Lindsay Gilby a couple of times and now out-muscled him, which I wouldn't have thought was on the cards.
He's only just gone on to him, Gary. He's been playing on Uze Gilby, has he not?
Okay, Brian.
Davey, for his second in the term, left foot kick on the way. It looks like it's bleeding left, and it is.
Just be careful, Jim.
Not going to mention him, Gary.
Just be very careful where you go when Lindsay's involved.
Oh, no, he's a very fine player. Here he is, kicking in from fullback. Makes Davey on, and Davey going for the cheap shot high to the head of Gilby there. Playing the advantage. Ray under pressure.
Ooh.
Look at the pressure, the Demons. Turnover complete, Uze. Johnston got Davey on, handball back inside. McLean.
I reckon that one, that goal there will delight Neil Danaher, because I would imagine that has been the plan. You've got to run these blokes down, chase them from behind, and the pressure just, I hate to say it, he just got to Lindsay in the end. He just handballed to no one, and the ball's turned over, and it's cost a goal. And that is the way Melbourne are going to play against the Western Bulldogs. They need to chase them down. That's why Aaron Davey becomes almost the most important player on the ground. He'll be wrapped with that.
Out to a 14-point lead, the Demons. Scotty West back on the ground. Try and give the Dogs some spark. Centre square infringement. And it's picked up by Matty James, so it's not a centre square infringement. It's a free kick. Going to go to big Will Minson. Wide to Boyd. Boyd to McMahon. dangerous on the left boot, has a long ping at him, but pulls it away to the right and through for the first behind for the Dogs.
Still 7 minutes remaining in the quarter. Good kick in. Nice Bartram. Looking for Holland Street. Did well defensively. The big fella just back onto the ground, replacing Minson in the last 10 seconds.
Davey now got a new opponent. The young boy, Damien McCormack, playing fullback effectively on Aaron Davey. That would make you nervous.
McCormack in just his third game of footy. Who's that going against? Street, new, the player new. The advantage paid, Boyd. A bounce, short kick. Is not far enough, fair enough, umpire. No mark in that, barely travelled 10, never mind 15. Picked up by Smith. Just needed a bit more on it, Johnson was ready to go. Bruce's handball, under some pressure, Carroll made the handball look better than it was. Now the kick, Sylvia and West. Battle it out, support. Third man of the contest in Ward. Got rid of it very quickly, didn't he? Bartram, West won't let this one go. Will he be penalised? No, he won't. Ball up.
Tell you what, Gaz, credit to the Dogs, because not too many teams crack in as hard as Melbourne as a rule, but the Western Bulldogs at the moment are having a real dip.
No doubt, no doubt.
Physically hard at it, as most Rodney Ead teams are. Uze, there's Gilby. Uze got it back out again. Johnston with a forward handball. Oh, Brown was met solidly by Harris. Here's Gilby. Beautiful kick to Smith. Screaming forward, a bit of candy sold, and then the long, long ball that's going to go all the way.
Set up by Gilby off half back, Ryan. A beautiful pinpoint pass. Rowan Smith, this is a really important time in Rowan Smith's career. This is a side, the Western Bulldogs, who, I mean, they've got the talent to finish inside the top four, and who knows what can happen from there. And it's just so important that Rowan Smith is there to cash in on the success that comes with the Western Bulldogs. Good work on the line by his great mate.
Dogs not back in business. Melbourne look like they're playing the slightly better footy, but the scoreboard suggests very even contest. West, this time they are on him. McLean tidies up. Davey, one out. Down there with McCormick. Ground level ball dispute. Hargrave somehow got it to McMahon. And his non-preferred right wasn't great. McDonald. Quick hands, Bartram. Now Ward can run. Kick wide. Johnston can run. Thinks only about centering the ball initially and then out of ping. And pretty ugly attempt.
One of those players, Travis Johnston, that you make some concessions for him because he is so talented, but you'd expect him to do better than that. Ward is having a magnificent opening quarter. He started on Farron Ray, racked up 9 touches on the wing.
As hot as he is, Gary Robertson is cold.
Hasn't touched it.
Has not touched the football. It's amazing for a player of his talent and stature in this Melbourne side. Harris. McMahon will leave it for Baird.
This the stop-start, though. This is the thing that Rodney Ead will want to get this ball moving. Try and get some more movement.
McMahon plays on to Baird, which guarantees movement. He goes to Johnson. Ball bounces in front of him over the line.
Let's go down to Chris Jones' ground level.
You just mentioned Russell Robertson. His left knee is heavily, heavily bandaged, much more those than in recent times.
Make a concession. I don't think we'll make a concession there. I just don't think he's been near it.
Three. Can be brutal sometimes, Gary.
You can. Well, if you run out there, Brian, you're playing.
Get out of place. And boy, who's eight? Byron has been quiet. Players converge and the umpire will be forced to blow the whistle here.
There's Russell Robertson. Byron has been quiet. He's just wandered on Riser off the bench, but he'll get busy.
Exactly why he's been quiet, Gary.
Yeah, you're absolutely right.
Gilby was tackled very high. Griffin off halfback. Billing's going to be one of those sort of days. Johnson Harm Ford turns around, good looking kick cross, got to do it in the air. Ford getting back, but didn't want to infringe. In doing so, allowed Cross free grab at it.
Got forward a bit more, Daniel Cross, in this first quarter. He's had it such a great year in the middle of the ground. Just a nice position to be in when you got your defender running with a flight of the footy back to the ball. It's an 80% chance of getting a mark or a free kick, I would imagine.
This to get the Dogs within a point. Cross has already kicked one and been goal for goal basically in this first quarter. Daniel Cross, only about 30 metres in distance, good look at it. Kick on the way is there, so the Dogs are within a point.
Yeah, it's an interesting one. I wonder if it's he's making a concerted effort to push forward more Daniel Cross. But if he adds that to his game, he becomes an even more rounded player. Standing on centre wing at the moment hasn't historically been known to push hard forward, but the opportunity presents itself, you've got to grab it. And he has, and he's kicked two opening quarter goals.
Daniel Cross, just 6 goals for the season coming into today. He's already got 2. Uze. Celebration game, 250. Gets it to half forward. Sylvia, not favoured by the bounce of the ball. I think a free kick's going to go
Colin
Sylvia's way for a hold. Lots of numbers now in the forward 50 for the D's. Gets it up. A fly here from Neitz. Got hands to it. Was unable to complete the mark. And Chris Grant could bounce it all the way down the southern wing. Now he halts and spots a target in West. To Boyd. Now Gilby. Long use of the ball, sits it on the head of Johnson. Bruce did very well to effect a spoil, and then Carroll came in and controlled it well to Wheel, and then back to Bruce.
Bruce straight up the corridor, sees Holland, but Gilby getting in the way, right in the middle of the G, out wide. Grant sneaking down from defence on his left. Johnson, look at this, 1-on-3. He was the only one that kept his feet, though. Kept it alive, Ray. Dogs in front.
That is a fantastic result for the Western Bulldogs to have been chasing tail pretty much for the first 20 minutes of this quarter. But they've just worked their way back into it, and they'll be disappointed with that, Melbourne. And as you called it, Brian, 3-on-1, and Farron Ray kicks a goal. They put all their numbers back. Neil Danaher saw there's a minute and a half to go. Just all the numbers pushed back, and yet they still concede the goal. Just been a superb effort by the Dogs.
The Doggies. 3 goals in a row, and they're in front. Neil Danaher, not much he can do now except for just plan what he's going to say at quarter time, which is only a minute and a half away. Bartram. Off the ground, West. Bartram and Brown out there. That was nicely done. A couple of bounces. He's got the run of Ward inboard. Uses him now. To Byron. Over the top, and Bate needs the bounce. It didn't come. That's high contact. And Daniel Cross will take the free, and the Dogs are away again. That's a broken up handball in the centre. Cooney, though, to Griffin. Low from Griffin in search of Johnson. Beautiful kick. He is a very impressive young player, is Ryan Griffin. And this man's been impressive for a long time.
Heard Brad Johnson on the radio when we left the game last week, boys, say that Ryan Griffin is the best, in his opinion, young player to come to the Bulldogs in his time. Pretty fair rap when you consider some of the blokes that have been through there.
Brad Johnson to kick his second from the set shot. It didn't look right off the boot from the get-go, just a behind.
So a straight goal in it now, the Dogs' way. And Melbourne will be under some pressure here. The Dogs will know there's less than a minute remaining in the quarter and desperate to lock it in and give themselves one more chance. Whelan to White, cross in front. Now he's too far out. Don't think he'll get the distance from there. Works the ball long. Baird's got the set over the top. Big specky attempt. Ooh. Hit the post.
And hurt himself too, Roy.
Winded himself on the way down. Gets up limping a little. And have a look at this for a leap.
It's a good jump, isn't it?
That would have been very, very nice. Gary Moorcroft style. Sensational leap.
The Dukes didn't quite.
Jeez.
Come to the party.
When you get that high on a Sunday afternoon when we're calling, Brian, we demand the Dukes close around it. Just about quarter time here, and that's going to give maybe the Dogs one more crack here.
Well, the siren will come at exactly the right time for Melbourne because they've gone right off the boil. Dewey gone forward in the second half of that quarter and had an impact. So Rodney Eade, a little bit of shuffling, got a flexible outfit. He's going to have a shot, Brian. Call us through this, please.
Oh, well, he's going to go the spiral from here. Now, Lindsay is capable of a lot of things, but I don't think he's capable of this, Gary. He goes the mark that he didn't quite get. And Carroll knocking that to the safety of the boundary line. So a very, very interesting first quarter of football. Up until the 22-minute mark, it was goal for goal. After that, the Bulldogs kicked three in a row and looked slightly the better side late in that quarter. Let's go to a break with the Dogs leading by 7 points, 6-3-39 to the Demons, 5-2-32.
And he has to kick it to the Cats to win. The fate of the match riding on Peter Ricard. He leaves the boot. It's swinging back.
Classic Quarters, Monday on Fox Footy Channel.
Chicken nuggets. Oh, yeah, love them. But you know, not big enough unless you're a pygmy. However, Jack's understands hungry. Take a look at these mega nuggets. Now that's more like it. And they come with this freaky dippy sauce. Team that with a Coke and fries and you've made a meal of it. But wait, there's more. Marinated chicken wingettes. Oh yeah, just the thing when you're feeling peckish.
The burgers are better at Hungry Jack's.
Another moment of genius from Toyota. Most memorable grand final moment of all time. Specky of all speckies. Taken by another
yes!
man. Alex Jezelenko.
Jezelenko!
Dave, it's 1970, Blues versus Pies. Now, Jezzy, you stand here. I'll be Mackay. And Dave, you can be Jerga Jenkins. Happy? It's not... Dave, that was a really good suit. You've lost a little bit of the spring in your step.
Spring!
But I think all we need is leverage.
Little bit of leverage for Jezelenko! You beauty!
Oh,
Jezza!
What could go wrong? Nothing. No, that's not going to work. Not much height there.
No, it's time for plan B.
That's beautiful.
Mackay kicks it to the wing position. Oh, Jezza!
Jezza! You beauty!
Hey, boys. Wow. Hey.
Yes!
Nice grab.
Join us on Tuesday night, a man who owns 150 buses.
Great Essendon champion, Don McKenzie.
Plus a man started with the Swans, finished with the Pies and a flag, Shane Moore.
Then join me, Ron Barassi, for the best of round 19, 1985 on the Fox Footy Vault.
All part of your legendary Tuesday night on Fox Footy Channel.
The MCG, fine conditions so far, and we've got a bit of a shootout on our hands. 6-3-39 the Dogs for the Demons, 5-2-32 Daniel Cross, the only man who has managed more than one. It was the Demons for the better half for the most part of that first quarter, and then the Dogs just rattled home, banged on three in a row to finish
7 points up at quarter time. Let's go down to Chris Jones. Interchange bench, Jones, he's been working pretty hard.
Yeah, they certainly have. And I tell you, another person who was working very hard was the physio at the D's, working on Aaron Davies' calf throughout that whole quarter time break. You can see him right away from the main group. Now, there, interestingly enough, assistant coach for the Bulldogs, Leon Cameron, spent a lot of time with Damian McCormack, who went on to him late in that first quarter.
Good on you, Jonesy. Just Aaron Davies out there again, and McCormack his opponent. So just a little bit of a loosening at work.
Has to have icicles hanging off the ground before we allow an all-weather jacket on Jonesy. Yeah, Gary, what's going on?
I don't know. It looks okay from up there, but maybe it's chillier down there.
Start of the second quarter. Dogs by 7 points. McLean beautifully out of the middle. Robinson has timed his run. Didn't have a very good first quarter at all. Handball comes out. Godfrey. Neats in front. Dukes were good. Very solid against White. And I think if they get the ball in one-on-one between White and Neats, Neats is going to do this young man for strength.
It's a matchup you like, isn't it? Surprisingly, Harris was moved off Neats and went over to Holland. I would have thought that this man looms as a more dangerous threat.
Neats, here he is to line up for his second goal of the game early in the second quarter, and he has nailed it.
What would be the rationale behind that? Why would they be going with White on Neats when you've got Brian Harris, the one of the better fullbacks going around?
It's very risky, Gary. I've got no idea the rationale behind that, other than I see it as very risky.
Chris, you know, Chris Grant is... is that Chris Grant playing fullback? My eyes deceiving me.
No, it is, Gary.
Some strange matchups down in the forward line. Chris Grant's gone to fullback to play in Holland. The young boy White is on Neats, and Harris has gone to Jared Rivers.
That's all happening in the forward line. This is back in the centre. McMahon tipped it forward. West to Griffin. Both impressive players in that first term. Cooney back to West. A lateral ball finds Matthew Boyd. The cross. Cross inside the 50. Robbins. Carroll pushed into the ball in the end. Gilby. Little handball, missed its target. Bartram. Carroll having a good season. To Brown. Over the top to Ward. That's not a great kick. Gave Sylvia no option but to try and punch, and Hargrove was always in a better position. He goes into the middle. Cooney allows the ball over the top.
Good tap on in the end, JB. Chris Grant down on all fours, tried to sweep it on McMahon. Needed to get a bit more body there. White frees up here. Byron, bit of a step on Morris. Morris closed him down though. Byron may have hurt himself going to ground.
Yes.
Now Holland goes in board. Mark Harris. Byron Pickett's in trouble behind the plate.
He went to do that little dummy, that little fade and or feint, and he rolled his ankle or his knee, one or the other.
A Campese goose step.
Goose.
As Cooney just runs past, he's gone, Byron. They're signalling that they're going to take him straight from the ground and maybe even a stretcher.
Well,
he can't get up at all.
They're one down, aren't they? Right now, they're a player down, and he's just going to walk off the other side of the ground, Brian. Not worry about the interchange bench. That is, that's afternoon over, is it not?
If you walk off without going through the interchange bench, it does mean that.
If you're replaced, which Travis Johnston's now come on.
Kick forward in the meantime is Brad Johnson. That's bizarre.
Well, that would indicate that there's something very obviously wrong with him that means he won't be coming back.
Is it the afternoon, or does the 20-minute rule then kick in?
What they're going to do is they haven't had another player come on yet. I think they're going to... No, they have. Bader's now come onto the ground, so he's officially done for the day, Byron Pickett. That is it. They had a chat about it.
He's walking.
Yeah, very interesting.
Ooh.
All right. McLean. Uze shrugging the tackle. A little bit of pressure here, the D's, as White just wants to take a bit of time and settle it down and regain the composure that the D's had in the first half of the first quarter. Good looking kick. And Punched away. Ball in dispute now. McDonald with the hard one. Out the back door, West Street. Hands. McMahon. Cooney. The overlap. Cooney to Robbins. Robbins no good on the half volley. Got some spare defenders here, the Demons, although.
What was that?
Making a bit of a mess of it. Cam Bruce.
He jumped over it.
Right, and now Travis Johnson.
Ward will receive the handball from Johnson. Has a bounce. Approaches 50. Kicks to the square. Dangerous ball. Well done, Harris. Came back with commitment.
Causing some problems. There's Byron Pickett now. Hamstring maybe?
Yeah.
Or groin, I would suggest, by the looks of that.
Looked a little hammy, didn't it? Mm.
Very slow progress around to the Melbourne room, so he's not in a good way. Straight to the outer side is not a great kick. Naduze was able to close that footy down pretty easily to Whelan. The first gamer here in Jones.
And David Neitz has got wise again in that matchup, so really he should be trying to be isolated, I would imagine.
Godfrey. Just a high ball forward, pretty ordinary delivery that for your forwards. And a simple mark in the end to the champ, Chris Grant.
And that's why he hasn't spent more time at senior level, Simon Godfrey. Does every single thing you want from him, but it butchers the footy too often.
6 minutes into the second quarter, Russell Robertson still yet to touch the ball for the Demons. McMahon through the middle with space. Kicks on the angle, looking for Robbins. Will mark it. Well, Whelan lost it in the sun. So did Godfrey. I think Robbins even lost it for a sec. And now Robbins will line up. Let's go down to Chris Jones.
Just confirming, we checked with the umpire's advisor. Byron Pickett can't come back on the ground because he did go off on that outer side. He's almost made the rooms now.
Okay, so Robbins will line up, Gary.
I call Godfrey is turning the footy over. Was it not Godfrey? It was. And he's worked his way down to the defensive half now to play on Robbins.
And Power just coming onto the ground for the Dogs. He's yet to touch it either. Matty Robbins. Comfortable distance from him. Does kick the ball very high generally. This one offline. So a bit of a nothing second quarter after we had a goal-kicking fest in the first quarter. That's all dried up.
Still walking, which I'm no Doc Larkins, but probably is a good sign. The hamstring, it's not Matty Lloyd like off the bone.
The only thing that I'd say is that because he was so out of it, he must have said to the runner, that is it, mate, I'm off. Who knows, he's done some pretty severe damage.
Huzay gets a push.
Now, this is where it gets interesting. Harris is now on bait in the forward line.
Injuries at this time of year, Gary, start becoming very important.
He has been as influential as any player in Melbourne's colours, and if that's a six-week injury, then that could have come at a worse time for Melbourne.
Significant with the finals looming.
Yeah, well, that was the stage that Byron Pickett made his name, and particularly in the areas that perhaps the Demons have been lacking in a bit over time.
He knew straight away. And the game, as Brian Taylor correctly said, has ground to a bit of a halt. Brief flowing and open and attacking in the first stanza, but just at the moment, got the handbrake on.
Ask Gary why that is in a moment, whether it's the coaches that have put some moves into place that have slowed things up, or McLean. Head over at Jones, like that, McLean now. Standing start, McMahon not fully committed over the ball, Uze. Bit of a party trick. Gary, why has the scoring dried up, isn't
it? I reckon it's almost a compliment to both teams. Brian, is that they're being really accountable footy at the moment? That they haven't got that run-on flowing game that probably both sides play well? Like this chasing down here from the Melbourne forwards, this means that there's a bit of pressure on.
McMahon, risky.
And that's what happens.
Good mark, Brown. Plays on, tackled Gilby, got the handball away. Sylvia, Brown, low ball, good, McLean is marked. May have been Jones. It was.
Nice touch for the first gamer. Nice delivery, bit of composure. Only a young man. He's only, if he just turned 18, triathlete.
McLean with a very, very long run-up. He's kicking from 30, he's back in the centre square. And he jumps. Kick on the way. Looks very, very nice indeed. Melbourne with both second quarter goals.
It's a little difficult to know who's controlling the tempo. You'd probably suggest the Demons are, at this stage, just slowed it up. No 50-metre penalty. They're a good decision by the umpire. It's nice composure from a man playing his first game. Could have been excused for blazing away, but spotted up Brock McLean.
That style of delivery, Brian, the eagle being flattered by the comparison.
That's plop.
This might just doing enough to become my man, young Jonesy. His first game. Not yet, Gary, but
not sure he can carry that burden.
No, it's very, very early days. But as Brian said, he stuck his head over it, which was the terrific bit. Jamar out of the centre. Very nice. This man's been good, Sylvia. Tackled hard from behind. Power will pick it up. Right up in the air from Daniel Cross. And McCormack out there can't keep it in. Let's go to Chris Jones.
Gary Lyon, you were spot on. It's a left hamstring for Byron Pickett. The ice is already gone. He's actually sitting on the bench now.
That's not good news for Melbourne supporters.
Rodney Eade moving the players around the board as the D's start to just get a bit of control back. Godfrey Long pissed away from the dog defence. The bounce of the ball didn't really help White. Now he's in all sorts of trouble. I think he might have given away a free kick for high contact too.
Well, it's not pretty footy, but gee, Melbourne would be happy to have three goals. The only three goals of the game on the board in the first 10 or 11 minutes of this second quarter. There's the fend-off there that caught Ben Holland high. That's what the free kick's been paid for.
So Ben Holland to the city end to make it three in a row in this second term. Perfect view of it. Fair to say, Brian never really had a chance.
No, the Meccano man there, Ben Holland. Not even getting close. Harris just saying to the boys, I'm not kicking this in, someone else come and get it. And McMahon, who normally does this, along with Lindsay Gilby, will come back. Unusual to see that these days. Eagleton. Over the top. The Dogs have had it inside 50 a lot in this second quarter. As Boyd marches it up the wing. Power and Boyd combining again. A little overuse there. And Travis Johnston defensively in the middle was great. Boyd pirouetting, spinning out of trouble. Eagleton being quiet as well. Kick forward. Johnson caught behind Bruce Whelan. Met solidly by Griffin. Johnson. Eagleton on his non-preferred right boot. Top of the square stuff. It was good. Sun playing havoc down there at the moment, I would think, with those players on that side of the ground. Having trouble seeing it. And eventually Whelan conceding.
It's the pressure. This is the thing we look at here, is how much pressure is on the Western Bulldog ball carriers.
Good kick in from Whelan. Found Godfrey to Bruce and now Ward. Back to young Jones. To half forward. Sylvia had a fly at it. Went and got it again. Johnston, a dangerous player. Cameron Bruce to sit it up nice and high. Here comes Robertson for his first decent golden. Footy didn't land in his arms. He'll pick it up now. Still can't get a disposal, Robbo. Still can't get one. The umpire wants it.
He's been on the ground for 100% of the game, Russell Robertson. He's got three donuts next to his name.
He ended up with the ball there, but unfortunately the umpire blew the whistle for a ball up. Snapshot of goal by Holland.
Just a bit of a dangerous, little bit of a dangerous time for the Western Bulldogs. This is a bit lazy. This is just Ben Holland being able to do that essentially out of the ruck, and they're not pretty goals, but they keep sort of racking them up. It's going to be before you know it, it can get out to 3, 4, 5 goals. It's got to dig in here, the Dogs.
The Demons have kicked all 3 second quarter goals and now lead it by 11 points in an amazing second quarter, really.
like a flatness all over the ground, isn't it? The crowd are even.
Minton. Yeah, indeed. They've been good in the pressure areas that Gary has been describing. The Demons, very good. Pay particular interest to when the Dogs have got the ball, if you're watching this, and see what Melbourne do in terms of defensive pressures.
Just, you can't, they're too good a side, the Dogs, to allow them to run, and they'll carve teams up.
Cross. Minson. Cooney. Right, breaks, takes, runs. Can go all the way. Inside 50. Lets it rip. Just got tagged as he went to kick the ball.
Great example of the chase pressure from Bartram. He didn't get him, but he just put enough on.
Errol took the mark. Got it to Whelan. It must have been touched off the boot. Whelan's just got to dump it in space out there. Good kick in the end. McDonald's got Big Minnow. Oh, this looks best for a bit of a foot race. Taking him on. Actually, not a bad job from Minson. Yeah. He did well. Created some pressure with the kick, and now the Dogs can at least get a 50-50 ball on the outer wing as we go to Chris Jones.
Well, you mentioned the crowd was flat. There's absolutely no atmosphere down here at the moment, and all the crowd's behind us.
Yeah, well, they're just waiting for something to set this thing up and just set it alight. Not sure who that's going to be.
Ball thrown in. Picked up by Daniel Cross. His kick in the Carroll range. He went for Godfrey. Godfrey slapped it on. McDonald's had a terrific season. Carroll. Free kick's going to come back. And it's going to go to James McDonald. Just one of those, I think Brock McLean.
Who was
or maybe Carroll. We're going to work it out eventually, yeah. I guess.
Sorry, mate. My mistake there. Brock McLean only been on 70% of the games. Racked up 15 touches.
Travis Johnston. And Johnston nicely to Ward, who's had plenty of it.
Beautiful user, Travis Johnston.
Ward sits it up now for Uzay. Beautiful kick, lots of space. Perfect scenario for a forward.
Was a nice setup, and really one that the defensive coach of the Dogs will be having a look at, I reckon, just where they are positioned, their defenders. All the dangerous space was out this side of the ground. Just wonder whether or not they might have taken the first 5 or 10 metres. In the end, it was a beautiful lead, a beautiful kick, and not much you can do about it.
Adam Uze's got one already in game number 250. Oh, the drop didn't look great, but it's right through the middle. Four in a row now for the Melbourne Footy Club.
Yeah, you wonder whether maybe Brad Johnson will have a run on the ball for a couple of minutes, perhaps to get this thing sparked up a bit for the Dogs, because it's just been... It's just not slipping away as it did in the first quarter, because the Dogs were good enough to hang in there. In fact, got their nose back in front, but... It was a very ugly drop. You're dead right, Jimmy. He's been good enough to work it back in. Second goal to Uzo.
All right, well, the Dogs have kicked four in a row, and they now lead it by 17 points. Sorry, the Demons have kicked four in a row and lead it by 17. What can the Dogs do in response? We've got just under 8 minutes remaining in the half. Melbourne been very good in the second quarters, as they have proven here today this season. Cooney needs to lift. Gilbey with a bit of a helping hand. Now Smith got the run of the ball, but as usual, the Demon defenders are there in numbers. Handball over the top. Gilbey getting support, committed to the ball. Tackle was great. I think it may have been Carroll. Ball pinned to him, said the umpire.
Dangerous place for a ball up. That was a good tackle. Ken pushing the back in those situations.
That'd have been another little push there, but not given. Fair enough too. Umpire says you got to earn them. That umpire's Matthew James, one of the better umpires kicking around at the moment. Ball bounced in the Dogs forward 50, and they need one. Minson slapped it back, but McDonald, the only one there. To Jones, the first gamer. Some linking running here from the D's. Bartram out wide. Goes long in the Neats direction. The kick was astray from Bartram. And it's out of play on the full.
Got a bit of speed, Gary, when they get going, the Demons, haven't they?
Yeah, well, they're probably playing a bit more like the Dogs have played all year themselves. It's a good side, Bartram, young player that comes in, carries the footy well. He's got to finish better. That's an area that I'm sure they'll be working on with him.
Harris. Oh, very, very blasé attempted kick by Harris in that situation, but he makes amends now down the corridor with a couple of bounces. Kick in favour of Rivers, attacking the ball. Robbins did well. Bruce, Whelan, and now Rivers. Gilby did well with the smother. Back to Whelan. Carroll, electing to go wide, was looking for Holland. Oh, McCormack. Made a better deal of that one, the young man. The kick forward, Eagleton gets there at half back to take a safe grab.
Big ball winner, Eagleton. Normally only had 5 touches for the game, so that's a big win for Bartram.
Out across the Ray, and now Smith. Bob Johnson on longer if he wants, or he can go to the dangerous spot. They need a big marking player here, and they just don't have a body down there at the moment, Gary.
No, they don't. I wonder whether Brian Harris might be worth a go, Brian. He's been playing on almost a third forward down there. He's now gone to Neat, so maybe that move's been made.
And he can catch it, Gary.
They just need a big, strong contest. Jim's absolutely right.
What about Chris Grant, Gary? Do you take the risk and take him off one of the Melbourne tools? And
does he do that these days, though? Does he? I mean, he's much more of a mobile, hard-working sort of forward, is he?
Pick 22 for the year, so he's...
Oh, he's a forward. He's a dangerous goal kicker. If they need the long option...
Go forward with a big body, though. Gary, I'm sure if you need him there for just 10 minutes in a game, he's capable. Griffin to Johnson. One out. Here's a real contest if the boundary line doesn't beat them both. They had plenty of ground to work if the ball had stayed in.
Well, they'd be pretty happy with the Bruce on Johnson... match up at the moment. Melbourne just 1 goal to Brad Johnson, hasn't had great opportunity, but Cameron Bruce
tackles 29-9 there, 29-20 there in favour of the Demons. Davey, great hands. Rivers and McLean brushing the tackle. There's an advantage play there for the Demons, and they're away. Bartram through half back
gets it to Bate. The handball wasn't great, made him just wait for a second. Uze, this is Neats on a long lead. Good fist away from Harris. Grant was hit very hard. Harris has looked away, handball terrific. Hargrave now. Eagleton's got to sit under it and did well. There's Gilby on if he wants to use him. Handball to Ray from downtown for a much needed goal for the Dogs. It's going to land in play, maybe. Johnson, I thought, had a piece of it, but it's gone through for a behind.
He was claiming a high contact there, Brad Johnson.
He still smiles even when he gets a clip under the ear.
Cameron Bruce, his direct opponent. Kick into play has been nobbled by Gilby, and he is within range. And a very accurate kick normally.
4 minutes on the clock. That's not the sort of lazy mistake that you'd need if you're in Melbourne's position.
16-point lead to the Demons. Gilby runs around, opens the angle slightly, looking for it to bend right to left. It's going to be down to an aerial duel here. The back, Uze tidied up. Gained some valuable defensive ground. Grant and Holland going at it. And a boundary throw in. 60 metres around from the Dogs' punt rate goal.
Good old one-on-one contest, that one. No player within 50 metres of the two of them. Two big boys, Sue Holland and Grant. Street did well. Hargrove kicks mother. Boyd went back and looked to cross. Jones, is this not clean? And wrapped up in a Cooney tackle and taken to ground. Umpire having a good look at it. Now he wants it.
Dogs aren't getting any clean disposal.
No, no flow. They're off the boil a bit. I think a bit of it's a large part due to the pressure. Minson, the big body that's gone down, Brian. So he's standing in the goal square now while Street does a ruck work.
White got it wide. Boyd just unable to take it. Cross with a little handball. Bartram had to be clever and was. Just no clean ball for anyone at the moment. Tooney. Left foot inside the 50. That's nice. And Brad Johnson out in front of Bruce took it very cleanly.
Great delivery. I mean, it's 16 points. It feels, I don't know about you, Bucks, but it feels a lot more than 16 to me. So the Dogs can just pinch one, maybe two here on the siren. A good result.
Ball is in the hands of a good player. Darts it to the right. It's not going to get there. Big fist away from David Neitz. He's a long way from the goal square, but it was a timely piece of defensive work.
Players trying to bring the ball in from right to left down there, which is unusual. Normally it's the other way at that end of the ground. And both players, both Gilby and Johnson, missing in the last couple of minutes with the same error in judgment. Good ball, Carroll.
Oh,
there's the young man, Nathan Jones.
Oh, Robinson's first touch of the game. It was an absolute screamer. Driving ball inside 50. Holland, Harris is all over him. Shorty in the back. Gilby concedes under enormous pressure. Talk about the best one possession first half you've ever seen.
That's a good grab, isn't it?
Doesn't that just sum this bloke up? Yeah. He's done nothing and then taken the mark of the day for the first touch.
And that is, like a lot of players, a confidence player. That could be the thing that sparks him for a big second half.
The original spring heel jack. Good handball back from Gilby to Cooney, who has three very confident bounces to McCormack. Now White. Little ball for Farron Ray. I'm not sure that was the right option. White to pick it up. Kick smothered by White. Two Whites don't make a wrong bone. Farron Ray. Over the top, Hargrave.
Get the call in, Jim, please.
Able to slide it in, there's not much going on. That's a backward kick that was nicely worked in the end by Gilby.
Once again, a lot of possessions, but they lost ground in that passage of play.
Street in the centre. Can they get another one here, the Dogs? Take something into half time. Oh, Cooney left it behind. Good tackle from Bartram. And Bates away.
He is. Needs running support. Got it. Here's Neitz. Normally would be on the end of this. Now Godfrey. In fact, it's McLean. 70 from home. Waits for the troops to get in there. White's in a good position. If he's got the length, Davies in a great position. Here he is. Davies setting himself for the fly in front. Street did well. Still time for the Dogs. Just under a minute. Got some clean space in front for one of the rare times today. Eagledon running wider and wider. Now brings it back into power. Power to Farron Ray, barely 15. Folds some candy and delivers inside 50. Brad Johnson pushed out of the way. Nathan Brown just looking like an old hand.
He is. Handball over the top by Travis Johnson. J-Mar has it. Gives it back to Travis Johnson.
It's a good example of what this half been about, isn't it? I mean, the Bulldogs had that run and got held up and turned it over.
Oh, good hard footy from McLean and a great tackle from West. Spun him around a couple of times. Hargrave to Street. Oh, big Streety. Just going to have to pump it down the line because there wasn't much on, but that's half time. And a 4-0 second term from the Melbourne Footy Club.
Only the second goalless quarter for the whole year for the Dogs, so that's a big win for Melbourne. That is a big quarter of football from a defensive point of view. There you go, look at the highlights of their halftime break. I'm not sure there are going to be many marks and kicks in this. This is about chasing and pressuring the best tackling side in the competition, arguably playing against the best running side. And right now, it's the Demons on top as we go to the halftime break by 16 points.
Every round, there's one quarter of football that you simply have to witness, whether it be a nail-biting finish.
Blues have tied it up again.
Individual brilliance.
Daniel Wells has kicked four, big run.
Or two teams going at it like prize fighters.
Three balls to save the neighbors and kill them.
The crucial quarter, Monday, only on Fox Footy.
I'd say come into Bunnings. We have biggest range around. If you can't find it at Bunnings, you're going to be hard-pressed to find it anywhere else.
Synthetic coir and rubber mat, only $16.90. 45-litre laundry tub, $159. Alec garden stake with timer, $29.98. Redline plastic toolbox, just $9.48. If you happen to find a cheaper price on a stocked item, we'll beat it by 10%.
Why don't you come down and visit us?
Bunnings Warehouse! Lowest prices are just the beginning.
Chicken nuggets. Oh yeah, love them. But you know, not big enough unless you're a pygmy. However, Jack's understands hungry. Take a look at these mega nuggets. Now that's more like it. And they come with this freaky dipping sauce. Team that with a Coke and fries and you've made a meal of it. But wait, there's more. Marinated chicken wingettes. Oh yeah, just the thing when you're feeling peckish.
The burgers are better at Hungry Jack's.
Exclusive to Headliners.
The first night we trained, we didn't have balls, we didn't have outfits.
It just looked like a B-grade side from down the road.
A team divided.
There was still a lot of love, but a lot of hate. We just finished getting thumped by Port in the grand final. And then 4 weeks later, we're training with them and trying to be best friends with them.
An astonishing 1991 debut punctuates the AFL arrival of the Adelaide Crows.
We absolutely smashed them, you know, smashed them.
The conclusion to the birth of the Adelaide Crows, Wednesday.
Welcome back to the MCG. Big half of football coming up in the context of this whole season. If, as the conventional wisdom suggests, you need to finish inside the top four to have a real go at winning a premiership, well, this half of football becomes now the most important half that both of these sides have played. Before we get underway for the third quarter, let's head down to the boundary and Chris Jones.
Thanks, Gary. Well, the good news is it looks as though the rain's going to stay away. The bad news is it is very, very cold. And it is starting to gust down here at ground level. Believe it or not, too, it's pretty dark. Now, Byron Pickett, we'll just update you on him. He's done that left hamstring, and there you can see him walking to the into the rooms at halftime. He's going to miss at least 3 to 4 weeks. This is the incident, Gary.
Yes, well, straight away he indicated to the trainer and the runner that he was no good. That's a very technical medical term there, Brian. And just walked off the other side of the oval.
I think it was the forced goose step.
Yeah, it looked like it, didn't it? Oh, I thought at first it might have been an ankle, but just such an important player has had such a massive impact on this Melbourne side that he's going to be very sorely missed. They'll be working overtime to get him back for September.
Indeed, they will. And as you rightly say, both of these sides vying for a spot in the... There's the Bulldogs head trainer just consoling Byron Pickett as well as he walks past. Both these sides fighting for a spot in the top four. And the Demons can remain in third position outright if they win here today. And the Dogs would go equal on percentage in third.
Well, that's so important, isn't it? See what's happening down the forward half for the Doggies. That's the area that they've just struggled in that second quarter particularly. Farrell will score a goal. Big half of footy, Ryan.
Melbourne by 16 points. Start of the second half. Street left to do it alone. Did well. Nathan Jones. McLean. Away, Bruce. Gathers. Time to look, even to bounce. From outside the arc, got a good position in front. Did Robinson, couldn't complete the mark. Got a little kick out of the pack now, Brad Johnson.
He's gone back, Ryan, as he did last week, just to try and generate some run.
Gives it off. Hargrave, the West Australian, kicks out wide, looking for Cooney. Ward to tidy up. White, they set up the handball triangle. James McDonald, chipping ball over the top, and the Demons have found Neitz.
Well, they've got four men on their forward line, the Western Bulldogs, and the rest of the side are getting behind the footy, as we saw last week, and I think when they get possession, they are just going to try and run at the ball from one end of the ground to the other.
Neitz, two goals, Gary. The first one coming in the first 2 minutes of the game, the second one coming in the first minute of the second quarter, and here we are, 1 minute into the third quarter, and Neitz with a very good-looking kick. He's tripled it.
An important kick, isn't it? Just to get them up and about again for the Demons, and as you pointed out, he's opened up each of the quarters with a goal. James McDonald, very good player, massive rap for him, just gets the job done every single week.
and gets put onto very good players for opposition sides. He's now, looks like he might have gone to Cooney, but I reckon maybe the mindset now for opposition sides is they're going to go to him. The skipper's having a good day, 3 goals.
Some worrying signs starting to sneak in for the Western Bulldogs. Demons have kicked the last 5. White down to McLean, picked up by McMahon. Long ball inside the forward 50. Carroll leads Grant to the footy. Thought he might have been taken illegally. Umpire lets it go. Goes back and gets it, does Carroll. Rivers' hands weren't overly clean. McDonald did really well to get it to Carroll. Whelan now to Jones. Jones to Carroll. And McDonald, as they just sort of work it around in a circle, the Demons.
Just fatten the stats nicely there.
Yeah, absolutely. Have a look at the head on this man. Just really wondering where he's at with it as bait.
Now, at that centre bounce, Melbourne had 8 forwards, an 8-man forward line. They refused to let the Dogs have a spare player in their forward half.
Spending too much time with Danny Frawley. Carroll, that's clearly part of his problem. No, taken in the back. Brian by Matthew Boyd.
Danny, of course, assisting down there from time to time with the defensive unit. And Nathan Carroll, his main pupil.
Yeah.
Handball was sloppy from Cooney. Didn't have the legs. Davey just scooted through. Time to compose himself and find White.
Implied pressure again, I reckon, Brian. It has caused the turnover.
Robinson on the lead. He didn't come strong enough, though. He went, he stopped, and in that time, White had already kicked Gilby.
This is where the run's going to come now, Brian. They've got numbers back.
The open forward line for the Dogs, if they can get it over the traffic here, they'll have plenty of room to use the ball. Eagleton encouraging Grant to run with it. And he does. Now he brings it back to the corridor. The long kick in. Robinson, Johnson. Wheeler getting Robinson under the ball nicely at the end. And a minor score.
That's the result they're after, though. That's the style of game they're trying to implement. And they did go the distance. They'll be encouraged by that.
Bruce kicks to himself. He's got a long target in Godfrey. Decides to go to McDonald instead by hand. He kicks in the Neats direction. Got a little shove. Godfrey's in good position now. The bait, who was being tackled as he accepted that handball. And the spillage comes to the Dogs. Straight to West. The Cormac. No Dog anywhere near this particular situation. They've been breaking down badly in that area today, the Western Bulldogs.
Free kick off the footy goes to Bartram. Same result. The stop start, Jim. Just a stop start movement down the ground, which gives defenders an opportunity to get themselves set, filling holes. No result for the Dogs.
Nathan Jones, the first gamer. It's not a bad thing to do in your first game either. Just see the skipper and pump it in his direction. You'll never get criticised for that, Gary.
Look at this pressure.
Well done, Boyd, to get back and try and work it, but he's copped it up to Davey. Street's not catching him. Left foot shot's there.
Pressure. That's the result that they would be after. That is how they would have planned for this game. I've got no doubt about it. And you've got big Mark Jamar there doing the work. Gets up for a second effort. Lays another tackle. Rivers joins in the party. It just becomes overwhelming in the end. Big Peter Street against Darren Davey at ground level. You know what the result's going to be there. That is just a fantastic result for persistence and all-in pressure.
Sitting next to Gary here on a Sunday afternoon, James, just really opened my eyes to what Melbourne are very, very good at. Just the press of defensive skills, Gary. Just highlighting that magnificently for us.
Too often?
Oh.
Yeah.
No.
It's here today and it's obvious as Cooney. Couple of bounces, launches from beyond the arc with a good looking ball. Robbins on the line. Baird overrunning the ball. Carroll comes at him hard. Eagleton pursued. There it is again. Look at them. Every time the Dogs get possession of the ball, there's a demon coming at them. And Rodney Eade, frustrated because of that. Very few clean possessions for the Dogs.
Gaymar works it down. Ward, I think the kick was touched. Gary mentioned how good a player this bloke is, James McDonald. And that's a terrific kick under pressure. It's going to work beautifully. Pope can give it to Uzo. With plenty of room to move, it can go all the way. Two bounces. Go with it in your 250th, young man. Hits the post.
Row, he's gone and celebrated.
He was.
He was acknowledging the crowd. And it hit the post. That's a bit embarrassing.
Long time for me. Did he actually high five someone? I want to go back and look at that on the replay if he does. Because that could get him the tour of the week without any doubt whatsoever. Street, Eagleton on his favourite left. Drilling ball. Robbins. Well and read it better. Overcooked at the kicker. Eagleton. And Whelan says we'll just regain our positioning. And here he is, celebrating. Look, turns around, has another look, and goes, oh no. I just cooked it a little early.
Yeah, ever done that, Brian, in your illustrious career?
Never done that, Gary. Never celebrated early. Always waited for the decision to be made. Bartram. For the Demons. It's a hushed MCG here at the moment.
It is. I reckon they're a bit stunned. I think the Dogs supporters in particular thought they were going to come here and see this free-flowing running game that's served them so well.
Well, Ignite, if the Dogs can get a two or three goal run, this game will be brought back to life.
Well, their last goal was in the first quarter of the 28-minute mark.
It was indeed, Gary. Baron Ray just before the quarter-time siren. Harris McMahon.
Over his head, he's got to commit to the footy. Bate came terrifically strongly at him. Gilby now, good work from Bate to put another tackle on. This is Cross. Now McMahon, inside the 50, that's a better kick. And Baird can accept that right in the bread basket.
Yeah, well, even given that, you still get a feeling that if they do bang a couple together, that maybe it could open up for them. They can score pretty freely and quickly. And despite the dominance of Melbourne in probably since quarter time, they're still only 28 points up.
Two goals so far this season for Travis Baird. Only kicked three in his career. Mind you, it's only a three-game long career at the moment. To the city end of this famous ground. Right-hand side, that one. And just a behind.
I reckon that was a bigger kick than he placed importance on it. Just hanging it out to the right-hand side. Umpire says to Daniel Ward, you're going to have to play on. You've had plenty of time. And we've seen Melbourne every time have been able to play on from full-back. Davey takes on the young fellow and says, if you're going to play league footy, this is how quick you've got to be to stay with me. Wheeler. Delivery to Robinson. Half volley. Morris doing well to Harris. The don't argue on Neats. Back to Morris now. Gee, they're under pressure. Look at this. Every time they get it, Gary.
Chase them down.
They are being corralled, harassed, and worried. Look at this.
Forced them backwards.
Boyd. Forced them sideways. Oh, Gary's all over it here today.
Oh, sharp. I'm going to whack you in a minute.
Sharp.
Think you're taking a bit out of me.
McCormack in the centre. Good kick to Griffin. Need to get him back involved. Hargrave now. Long ball to Johnson, and why not? Couldn't get hands to it. Bruce has actually done a pretty good job on Johnson. Ball stays in. Baird picks it up. And the concession in the end by Rivers was good.
Free kick, I think.
With supreme pressure. You might be right, Jared Rivers. Oh, a nab rising start. And over the top, Brock McLean. Godfrey, or Nathan Brown, is just on the ground. Brown to Ward. Takes on Big Street, who did well. Put a good tackle on McDonald. Terrific player. McLean trapped. Back to Ward. Hits it up high. Neats in from the side. Got good purchase on it, but couldn't take the mark. Harris. The ball was too hot for him. Brown. It's really scrappy stuff. Neats. To the hot spot. Sylvia. Whelan.
Oh, the back
pocket, the little back pocket. And it snuck down, that ball just hung in the air a little longer than it looked like it might have. And he summed it up really well. Came across the front of the pack. And he enjoyed kicking a goal, Matthew Whelan.
Just 12 in his 118 game career. Right in front. Away to the right.
Brad Johnson is down on his normal output. I mean, do you leave him there all day or do you get him up and give him a run on the ball? I think he's too important. He's had 8 possessions.
5 minutes, maybe even this last 9.5 minutes we're about to play, Gary. Might be able to just prime his team into action. Scotty West pushing that one to the boundary. Just run into a brick wall every which way they turn at the moment, the Dogs. And the clearances there. Brock McLean showing just how important he is in that area. Minson, beautiful tap West. Driving ball, Whelan working back courageously. Carroll's caught, ball pinned to him very clearly and cleanly. Got to go again now, Whelan. Did he kick it or handball it? Don't think he did either. Umpire gave him the benefit of the doubt, Whelan, and will ball it up. Whelan struggling to get up there.
He's brave, Whelan, Gary.
Yeah, he is. He's always reckon he's just about the best tackler in the competition. He's got a strong rugby league background.
I mean, it's perhaps slightly different when you're Glenn Archer and you're bringing 70-odd, 80-odd, 90 kilos into that contest, but he's not a big man. That was terrific. Sylvia wide. Nothing to kick to at all. Rowan Smith back to take it. Need the next goal, you sense the Dogs. Harris. Low ball here. Robbins, kick won't get to him. Rivers took it and gave it to David.
I'd like to know how many times they've gone inside 50 the Dogs like that and missed the target. Smith. Johnson. Wants to get back on the right as it got the wheels high. Grant on the line. Just missed.
A bit sloppy there from Melbourne's point of view. A little bit of pressure from the Dogs. Yeah, they do. They need a spark somewhere. They just have had no flow. And I also reckon they've been messy and missed targets like they haven't missed targets for much of this year. It's been a highlight of the way they play their footy, is how precise they can be, but certainly not today.
The last 5 minutes they've drawn the battle. They're pressing the Dogs without reward at the moment. Still not with that clean ball they're used to getting. Nevertheless, they're getting their hands on it. Here's the first gamer in Nathan Jones. High ball. This man here, White. I'm not sure that he's actually ready for league football yet, Gary. I think he's got a bit to learn, but the Dogs being forced to elevate a few earlier than they would have liked. And yeah. I think he might be one of those.
Yeah, they weren't afraid to whack him on a David Neitz early in the piece, so they've got a bit of faith in him, but then maybe that's just because they haven't got options. Matthew Bates' effort back then in that marking contest wasn't good enough.
Bartram, Sylvia, the first gamer, Jones. Just pumps it long. Uze now got to make a contest of it. He was dealt with illegally, was he? No. Yeah. The free kick is going to go with the marking player, Boyd. Griffin's on. Low ball, Cooney. Can he create something? Left foot, nice. That's better.
It is better. And hopefully that is Chris Grant, who just hasn't followed the general play down. He's actually gone to play as a key forward because they do need someone other than Brad Johnson to go to. We know this man is just a superstar of the game. Good converter. And look, this important kick. Back to 21 points, he kicks this guy.
Well, you don't slot 544 without knowing where the big sticks are. Chris Grant, big goal this for the Western Bulldogs. Ah, very well done. That's fantastic.
Are they going to catch fire? I mean, is this crowd going to catch fire? The players going to get on board? Just Grant's gone down, Cooney's gone down there, so it looks a little bit more threatening. Baird's playing deep. Brad Johnson has he's been moved. to the wing at this particular stage, just a bit of freedom around the middle of the ground. But 21 points.
All right, back to a 21-point margin. And I just get the feeling that the Dogs, as I mentioned, have drawn the game over the last 7 or 8 minutes. And they're just waiting for a bit of clean ball now. And it's coming their way, Whelan at half back. What would really hurt them is if Melbourne were to score now. And it looks threatening. Bruce is going to be able to waltz inside 50. Send a long ball home. It's offline. And in the end, it'll be out of bounds. So a let off there. Oh, in fact, it stayed in. Well, Godfrey's on the side doing his warm down. He's saying to the boundary umpire, it's out. Boundary umpire was there, had a good view, and said no. Every one of the players had stopped playing.
Oh, well out. Well out.
And Minson just able to trundle away with the ball. And here come the Dogs again.
All right, this is a big, big 5 minutes, Brian. You caught it beautifully, I reckon. Another goal here and a bit of momentum. Head of steam up. They're not out of this by any stretch.
Chris Grant wanting something. Cooney's deep. He goes short. Not 15. Boyd will be forced to play on. Now he's got Griffin. Needed clean hands. Was perched over. It was a difficult bouncing ball. Demons out of trouble here. Bate. Takes Farron Ray on. He's got running support in Davey inside. Gives it to him. Davey did it well. Neats. Harris has got to go in. He does. Ball in dispute. Bate there. Neats' recovery was brilliant. Kick to the advantage of Robinson.
Oh, this is a game of inches. I mean, that ball, Western Bulldogs inside forward 50, just some really good tackling and pressure from the Melbourne defence, and all of a sudden, Russell Robertson is having a shot at the other end of the ground. Good recovery from a big man, good lesson there. Got to get up, get yourself back involved in the contest, and nice delivery to Russell Robertson.
Two disposals for Russell Robertson. One of them was the mark of the day, and could this be a very, very encouraging goal for his team? He's got it.
Well, it's one of the dangers when you got the other thing with Cameron Bruce is when you've got such a good player as Bruce playing on Johnson. Johnson leaves the square, comes up on the centre wing to try and get involved, and all of a sudden Cameron Bruce becomes a really dangerous attacking threat as well. So it's one of those ones you've got to weigh up. But yeah, he's been very quiet, Russell Robertson, being one of the quieter demons on the park, but he's taken a hanger and now he's kicked a goal. So it always gives us something.
The Demons answer through Robertson. And it's still healthy if you're a fan of the Melbourne Footy Club. Put me on the scoreboard anyway. White to McDonald.
Maybe that's nice ruck work.
Johnston. And now Uze. Making a good fist of game number 250. Yeah. Very nice defensive fist away. Game from Morris.
Good player, Dale Morris. Very good player. Really beaten. I think they have conceded that Michael O'Loughlin might have been the only player that's really put him to the sword.
Going in. Donald cast in the role of a ruckman. Big Minnow just pushes him over the line.
Yeah, surely. Here comes Jeff White.
Need to get that matchup sorted out, you'd imagine. Exactly the same spot. The footy will be thrown back in again. White to hook it back. Travis Johnston and White for the Dogs. Ray down to Griffin, stripped of it. Well done, Travis Johnston. That was fantastic. Got it to Uze. The squaring ball from Uze is magnificent.
Now we can celebrate. He's brilliant, and that's just unbelievable. That kick, a left footer, he screwed it back, came back the other way, and he's tromped all over our effects microphone down there and kicked the goal. Johnson's a class act. The two of them have got a great understanding. Just a bit of a sixth sense between each other. There we go.
Uze with three goals. He certainly waited for the decision on that one before he celebrated. But in the end, it was great. Nathan Jones to Nathan Brown. driving ball. The Demons have put the pedal to the floor in the last couple of minutes and now led it by 33, nearing three-quarter time. Nathan Brown, biggest lead of the game, 33 points, Chris Jones.
Interesting to see the skipper, Brad Johnson, he's come to the bench for a rest.
Yeah, well, that's a victory for Cameron Bruce, who now goes and hunts his own footy, and young fella White starts to run with him.
McDonald, inside the forward 50 again. This is dangerous, always, Davey. Handball over the top, McLean to Johnston, he's another one, no. Just a little fierce with the handball. And that's a good result for the Western Bulldogs. A rush behind and they'll get the footy back at half-back through Cross. Ryan Smith, courageous. Eyes on the footy and he got buried. Not sure if there was much in it, but reward for courage as much as anything else. All the eyes just focused on the footy there. It's terrific. Griffin, this is dangerous. Away from Neitz. Standing start shot from Griffin, just away to the run.
I saw Ryan Griffin run down Gary Abbott last week. He'd be one of the quicker players going around. David Neitz, who's 30 or whatever he is, he chased him down, just got a hand on him. That sums up where the Demons are at today.
McDonald very easily around Baird and takes Minson on the inside with a handball to White. The give and go now with Uzay. Centering ball, Robinson in front, knocked it down nicely, gave his ground level players like Davey an opportunity. That is great awareness. That was deliberate. Saw him out of the corner of the eye there, Bruce. No doubt that Aaron Davey meant that to happen.
That our Bulldog, the Bulldogs today, Brian, with their movement, that run that was James McDonald featured in on three or four occasions there, that's the style of game that the Dogs have employed so well. They just ran it in a wave. Got into a contest, and now, as I said, Brad Johnson off the ground, so Cameron Bruce becomes an attacking threat in his own right.
The Demons have owned the last 6 minutes of this quarter as Bruce comes in and just leant back and pulled it to the left. Minor score.
One thing that we wouldn't want to see, Neil Danaher, is any sign of blairising or perhaps starting to get away from the things that have made them get to this position.
They've kicked eight of the last 9 goals of this match, the Demons. Down the wing, Eagleton, the kick was strong. Picked up by West, who gives it back to Eagleton. Piercing ball over the head of Carroll. And Rivers, you sense, might concede he does.
Ooh, less than a minute to go. Safety first option, or will they try and kick another goal? Looks like the safety first option is going to be the way to go. Jeff White marks it and just immediately goes back and slows things down.
Under 45 seconds remaining, a 33-point margin.
Fill in your records right now. I reckon they put it away for the quarter.
Nathan Brown just happy to maintain that position, as Gary has highlighted. White coming off for a spell, that available 29 seconds it'll get before the quarter, the three-quarter time break. All important for the big fella. McLean now forced to kick to a contest. High ball, Bruce, great mark. Couple deep he was, so now they can press a little if they want. Robinson, third possession of the day, out about it on the full, so that'll be it. McMahon, final seconds, third quarter, a 4-1 quarter in favour of the Demons, on top of the 4-goal straight that the Demons kicked in the second quarter. And they lead it by 33 points.
They do indeed. They would be delighted with that quarter. Be delighted with the game plan and the way they've been able to shut down dangerous Bulldogs, including that man, one of the great players of the competition, Brad Johnston, having a very quiet afternoon by his standards. Still, a quarter of footy to be played here at the MCG. It's the Demons by 33 points.
Always prime time.
I'm just happy this show starts at 7:30.
Always the place for news.
Are you sure about that?
I'm sure. Ask the coach.
Well, I get all my information from the news reports of Fox Footy.
Always more than one opinion.
Let's get our head on telly.
Tony, and you're off the mark.
Sure.
Oh, you're off the mark.
You can't allow that to happen.
Anthony
in the middle. Look at that. Quite brilliant, wasn't it? Driving ball forward. There's a contender. He'll be past the centre. Johnson takes the mark. How's that for a coast-to-coast goal?
Charlotte. Good delivery.
Your complete AFL match day guide. The facts and stats you need to know, plus the stuff you've always wanted to know. Grab a copy of the new AFL Record.
One touch opening. A vibrant screen. 1.3 megapixel camera. Bluetooth connectivity. And a music player that fit your lifestyle as perfectly as it fits your hand. The new Nokia 6131. Fits you. Nokia. Connecting people.
Subscribe to Ringtone King and get rid of that annoying SMS forever for the Gunners Classic. Text GOLD41. 100 to the Foxy Lady. Text GOLD42 or text GOLD43 for Body Rockers. Or for... Get Dr. Dre by texting GOLD44. And finally, for Sweet Home Alabama, text GOLD45 and send to 191818.
Thursday on Fox League Teams, join Footy's esteemed panel of all-stars for the latest team lineups and to-the-minute football analysis.
Take that out of the game. We're getting the garbage footy and we don't want it to come out in the public and do that. It reeks of arrogance.
Don't say Mark Harvey didn't instigate that.
Fox League Teams, live Thursday on Fox Footy Channel.
Good 250th game is Adam Uzay. The Demons lead by 33 points at three-quarter time, and Uzay and David Neitz, the leading goal scorers on the ground, with three apiece. Aaron Davey and Brock McLean with two. For the Western Bulldogs, they kicked six goals in the first quarter, and it's been hard going since then. Neil Danaher out, I'm sure, impressing upon this group of players that they have got to this league by playing a style of game that has worked well. And I'll be pretty sure he'd be demanding that they do not deviate for that. There was one or two little instances late in that third quarter where I thought that maybe they went from the plan a bit, but three-quarter time comes at a good time. What about the Dogs? I mean, they've been flat and disappointing since quarter time.
They have. They haven't been able to find any spark at anywhere, really, Gary, except for the first quarter where West got amongst the ball a bit. And they haven't been able to find anyone up forward that has been able to win easily against an opponent or a midfield dominator.
Find out whether they can find that player very shortly. There are two other games going on around the country. We've got a final score for you from the Kangaroos and Geelong game at Manuka, and a progressive three-quarter time score from Carlton and Fremantle. If you don't want to know those scores, look away now. Quickly down to Chris Jones before the fourth quarter gets underway.
Well, the D's, they've won 8 from 8 at the MCG this year, and they're not going to let this one slip. You saw Neil Danaher, he was much more animated than Rodney Eade at that three-quarter time break.
Start to the final term. Good bounce. Missed by Power. Boyd got it off to West. Little don't argue. Free kick going the Dogs' way. You can score quickly in modern footy. I reckon risk-taking might have been part of Rodney Eade's message. They've just got to roll the dice here, the Dogs. Cooney. Gilby. Met solidly by Ward. And now White. Melbourne away through Godfrey. Inside the 50 to Neitz is good. Long way from home. Fits it up high. Holland in the square has a run at it. Bartram at ground level picks it up and kicks a goal.
Whoever told you football is a complicated game, kidding themselves. That is, the mistake was made by Cooney, didn't get his hands out. Ball comes down the other end, top of the square, strong contest. That's all that Holland needs to do. Bartram, front and square, A1 position, goal, the result. Ben Holland doesn't need to get 30 touches or 20 touches or take 10 marks. He needs to give a strong, fierce contest that the Dogs haven't had. Give a crumb for those blokes and bang.
A game-high margin of 39 points. The Demons looking for their 12th victory of the year. Seems they may well achieve that. Jeff White. Uncharacteristically slipping over there in the middle. McMahon run down again. How many times have we seen this today? And Boyd didn't dispose of it correctly either. And Ward will get himself a free.
Yeah, the tackle from Daniel Ward was magnificent. It's been the story today. It's probably sounding like a broken record, but it has been so important. They put pressure on this side and they've done it beautifully.
McDonald liked his game today, Gary.
Yeah, always do, Brian. How's Lindsay going?
Bate. So good today. He's had one of his few down games. Lindsay. Gary. Right. Struggling a bit today.
Sweet.
But he's been a very good performer for most of the year. White. Sylvia. McCormick. Eventually comes out to cross. Good hands, Griffin. Attacked by a couple. One of those, Davey. Now McDonald. The give and go look for. Didn't receive it back, though. Davey found a bit of space for White. White launches from a long way out. He's got Holland and Robinson. Robinson positioning himself nicely. And in the end, off hands. And we'll have a boundary throw in.
Bartram continues to get big jobs, has had Eagleton all day, and he's kept into 13 possessions and pretty ineffective they've been, so it's a good win for a young man.
Street down, Hargrave got a handball away. But through Gilby, picked up by Bate. Sylvia, Brown, hooks it to the hotspot. Dangerous ball here, fist away. Godfrey picks it up. McDonald just unable to take the footy and was claimed. It's a scramble free kick. I think it might have been illegal disposal. It's going to go the Dogs' way.
Paid a throw. The umpire.
James McDonald said to him, have a look at the scoreboard. I reckon I handballed it.
Looked like a handball. But the instance on Friday Night Football where the umpire said, you have a look at the scoreboard and you'll see what I'm talking about.
Here's the big fella streak. Just waltzes through the centre, but I'm not sure about the delivery forward. And Bruce was able to take an uncontested mark.
Sees something he likes in the way of Jeff White. Now Bate can run and deliver. Robinson wants it low and hard, but he goes high and long. Holland. Robinson gathers between three Dogs, wants to take them all on. Got rid of it illegally in my book, but umpire says let it go. West to Chisler. Finds cross, the run of Smith. Powers gobbled up by an aggressive tackle from Whelan that should have been a free kick and wasn't. Godfrey.
Trip, I think a trip and a free kick to Godfrey.
I tell you, there will be sides that will not want to come to the MCG and see Melbourne in September, Gary. There's just a bit about him. Rivers. Pumps it to Neitz, but a free kick has been picked out.
Against Ben Holland, I reckon, for a screen, an illegal screen, right back in the goal square.
Chris Grant's going to take it.
Yeah, no, they played, and they play this ground better than anyone, too. Yep. I firmly believe that.
Kick from Grant, looking for Johnson. Johnson taken out of it. Travis Johnston has the footy held to him, tries to barge on through West. Sees the footy over the line, it'll be thrown in. Buddy West, 20 possessions again. I wonder how many games in the last 5 years he's played where he hasn't reached the 20 possession mark. There wouldn't be many. Cross, Robbins will get it back. That's a skill error. And the D's are away.
Bate will get on the end of this, and I reckon he can nearly run all the way. He wants to take Kilby on, he does. Now lights him up directly in front. Did he pull a little bit? He did. Set up beautifully from the half-back line for the Demons then.
This is as bad as we've seen the Western Bulldogs play this year, clearly. Their ball use and their turnovers, and they have really had a bad day.
Yep, Adelaide, their other bad loss in round five of 77 points. Other than that, they've been close losses. But today, they have been pretty comprehensive, the Demons, the way they've put their game plan into action and carried it out to perfection. Robbins, a little run. He's got one option deep, and that is Johnson. Johnson doubles back. Look at the back, look at the rain support. Demons are 3-on-1 there, 4-on-1 if you want to draw a line with them. Bruce, Johnson's making them earn it though. Davey now, with the back half for the Demons. Stops with Ward and combines with a give and receive. Uze has had a very good 250th. Nathan Brown able to run now. Now here comes Neitz at him. That's the target he's looking for. Got a good jump at it. Harris did really well just to nudge him out so effectively.
Into Boyd. Got some running support around him. Has a bounce. Hooney wants it long. Kick goes in that direction, and that's a good kick. Always favoured the man behind, and that was his teammate Adam Cooney.
And a good mark from Brian Harris. One out into the defence, sets this goal up, or was a shot at goal rather. Cooney's been okay without standing out at all. He's won a fair bit of the footy, made a few blues like most of his teammates.
There are the numbers for Adam Cooney. This has got to go through. That just about sums up the day the Western Bulldogs have had.
I just want to throw this one up to you, gentlemen. The Telstra Dome, the closed roof, the pristine conditions. Does it impact on the way they play when they get to a ground like this?
Well, I think the answer's with what we've seen today, Gary. Excluding the pressure that Melbourne have put on, but they certainly, skills are better in the closed environment. Here's an opportunity for them. Strong mark taken in the end by Grant. By the way, the Dogs have only kicked one second half goal to date.
It's almost one goal since quarter time, isn't it?
Exactly. That late goal on the quarter time siren. So it's really been a very disappointing performance.
Chris Grant, Grant equaling Doug Hawkins' games record today. Chris Hawk broke EJ's record, and next week, a big week, it comes the most played Dog ever. On the left foot, across the face, Chris Grant.
The tackle count was Western Bulldog 44, Melbourne 35, which surprises me enormously, but the effectiveness and maybe the tackles that haven't been counted, but ones where they just get a hand on. And
Chris Grant debuting back in 1990. Only one player left in the league, I believe, that debuted in the 80s, and that was Robert Harvey.
Long handball to Whelan.
A bit of trivia time.
Ryan, I've been talking with Danny Frawley.
Oh, Danny would know. Godfrey. Good mark, Minson, in front of Jamar.
Jamar?
Yeah, I got pulled up on that the other day,
is
Gary.
It Jamar?
Well, this is what the Melbourne people say.
Which ones?
They said to me, you've just been saying it incorrectly for a long time, Jim, it's Jamar.
Who told you that?
Fruit shop man. No, assistant coach down there.
Oh, all right.
Mark Riley.
Okay.
So I'm just going to have to take his word for it, I think, Gary. Eagleton over the top to Gilby. Through the centre with the long left foot ball. The 2-on-1 back here. And Carroll gets the handball off to Bruce. Bruce to Uze, who's going to be closed down by Hargrave. Slung in the tackle, and the turnover complete.
McCoy, Hargrave. Too far out for him to score. He's not a big kick of the ball at all. He's wanting someone to come at him. Minson just drifts down and marks inside 50. He will fancy his chances from here.
Going for his second kick, Will, for the day. Sorry, his fourth kick for the afternoon. And getting game time under his belt.
looking for his third goal of the year. This is his third game back since breaking his arm, was it? Very close to the man on the mark, Minson. And the kick at goal is great. He has got it.
I think it might have been a leg.
Yeah.
And he went and spent some time back
at Werribee.
At Werribee, and now they just sort of getting some game time under his belt as they head towards September. The Dogs, that is assuming that they will be there. A pretty tough run, I think, from memory, the Western Bulldogs in the next month or so.
Rodney Eade, not without his problems. Is those headphones a real work over? They have been terrific, though, the Western Bulldogs, especially when you consider the attrition rate. They've had injury, the like of which no other clubs had to put up with. Nathan Brown dealt with. Eagleton picked it up. McMahon. Whelan overcommitted. No, given away a free kick. Advantage paid. West to Eagleton. Dangerous left foot player. Long ball is going to go all the way through. Two in a row, Western Bulldogs.
No, I think he's had his colours lowered today, I would have thought. Nathan Eagleton, that is the mistake that caused the goal. Matthew Whelan there just over-committing and letting the ball get behind that pack. And from that point on, they're always going to be under some sort of pressure. Lovely finish. We haven't seen enough of this from these Bulldog midfielders. And Bartram, as I said, the player who was given the job on Eagleton and has done it very nicely.
Gary, I'm just going to ask you this question once.
Okay.
The Dogs are within 27 points, Gary. We've got 11 minutes remaining in the game. What are their chances from here of getting home?
Slim.
Are you sure, Gary?
Just hang on a minute.
Here they come. Kick is long, got under it bad. Carroll able to mark.
Well, stranger things have happened, Brian, but they haven't looked like it, have they, since that quarter-time siren. For the sake of the game, it'd be nice.
Kick out wide. Marked by Robbins. He's got Baird on him. Wants to go all the way. He's got some journey in the legs. Robbins lines it up. It's coming back a little. Minor score. So they're peppering the goals. Chris Jones, ground level.
We might have to check with the man himself. The bench are telling us it's Mark Jamar, not Jamar.
Okay.
Oh, Jim.
More than happy to stand corrected. I've called him Jamar for 3 years, so if that's correct, then I'm a happy man.
I think your mate Bob O'Reilly was just taking a bit out of you.
Wheeling over the top. Down the line, McLean. Sylvia, fisted away by Rowan Smith.
I know, it's the sort of question that Chris Jones should be asking the bench during a game.
And it's going to be thrown in.
It is when you're 30-odd points up.
Right in front of where Chris Jones sits. 6,500 fans, not a bad crowd. Minson, Cooney, McCormack. Little kick to cross. High ball. Rivers caught at the back, will fist it down. McDonald so often runs into the right spots to get the ball. Whelan, wide handball to McDonald. This is White, who'll give it back to McDonald. Pumps the long one forward. Holland with a big climb. Players falling down all over the place. Gilby off to Morris. And West is away.
He is from half back, but he's got nothing down the line, so they're going to have to run it. Powell bring it across here to the young man in McCormick. Just back of the circle, as you can see. It's the kick away in the nick of time. Brad Johnson elevating in front, though, was Rivers.
He's an important player too, this man, who had a down year last year after winning the Rising Star, but he's getting back into some very good form.
Got a bit of Adelaide about them, the Demons, the way they give the ball instinctively. Just give it because the guy's in a better position than they are. And you like that, it's a sign of real camaraderie and togetherness that Melbourne are building.
Looks like Daniel Ward has become an important player. Missed a lot of footy, good mark McMahon. But he kicks, generally, the ball pretty well and long.
Handball, Farron Ray, look at Davey Cody, gets the kick away. Johnson well placed here. Oh, Carroll from the front, terrific. Whelan's kick didn't spin properly but found White. Yeah, Nathan Carroll goes for a guy that a lot of people thought mightn't have what it takes to make it at this level, has had a terrific season.
Yeah, and this is a bigger story right here. This is a hamstring for Aaron Davey on the top of Byron Pickett.
Oh.
Then as good as this win will be, it could be disastrous. Let's go down to Chris Jones.
Yeah, I think you might be right, Gary. I think it's the right hamstring. He grabbed for it straight away, but I'll check on that.
Well, if you said to two players, you probably wouldn't want to have missing come September. I reckon they would be the two. I'm talking about Byron Pickett, if you've just joined us, who went down with a very bad hamstring early in the game. And here, Aaron Davey, the big long chase on Farron Ray.
Just in the last step, Gary.
Pulls up short. They would be the two, Pickett and Davey, I reckon I'd pick.
Oh, disastrous day for the Demons. Byron already off with a long-term hamstring.
And maybe
taken by Uzo. Didn't even know it was landing in his hands. And this man's had a fantastic day in his 250th game today. 24 disposals and has kicked already 3 goals. Oh, look at this. Turns his man around. Says, okay. Kept his eye on the ball. Didn't look like he did, so he knew it was there all the time.
He did keep his eye on the ball.
Remarkable talent this man has. There he is. Point blank range for him. And he's got 4 goals to cap off his 250th.
One in each quarter, an actual fact for Adamuze. So that is a very, very good afternoon's work from a most durable and talented footballer. He's had a great career, really has. Strong family up in Shepparton, brothers that play up there and kick hundreds upon hundreds of goals. And his father comes down and watches almost every game he plays. He's a very, very good footballer.
Chris Jones has an update for us.
Oh, he's really upset down here, Aaron Davey. He went and sat next to his mate Byron Pickett and was just shaking his head.
Yes.
It's low on the left hand, on the right hamstring though, Gary, which is probably a better sign than being high, I think.
Is it?
Yep. Well, that's where they're putting the ice.
Brock McLean. Nathan Brown and Godfrey. McDonald just socketed it through. Eagleton trapped the footy. Cross, West, Ray. Again, the pressure extreme from Melbourne, but that was too extreme. And Farron Ray. From Peel Thunder. In the West, Brian Taylor territory.
Ooh.
Down there.
Oh, yeah.
Don't worry about the fact that men are men down there, Gaz. It's a very, very hard part of town. Although, having said that, had millions of dollars spent on that Mandurah region recently.
A little bit yours, Brian. Any investments down there?
Fastest growing town in outside the major cities, of course. Town in Australia, Gary.
You are a font of knowledge.
I'm a millionaire's playground. That's a beautiful mark taken by Russell Robertson. Justin Langer, Australia's opening batsman, has bought a big waterside property down there.
Yep.
Doing it tough.
Farron Ray, he needs to get up and about if he's going to join that lusty group.
Long ball from Robertson. Big climb from White at the back. Cross. Couldn't find the ball. Morris was fierce, as was McDonald. And the umpire wants it.
Well, Gary, they're just getting over the news with Aaron Davey and Byron Pickett. That is unbelievable.
Yeah,
look, they're hamstring injuries, and they're not repeat offenders, but 3 to 4 weeks for each of those. And there's Melbourne's run, Gary.
3 of the 4 sides coming up in the next month sit outside the top 8. But look, it'll test their depth. And I think their depth is better than it's been for a long, long time. But
Holland snap.
Missed.
There's an example of some depth at the top end, the taller end. But I mean, they've got some players that can still come back in the side. But I mean, it's very hard to replace that sort of talent.
Short ball. Power. Into the centre, wanted Boyd to present to him. The crumb fell into the lap of Griffin. A couple of bounces, and then to Johnson. Bruce has done a very good job today. To Whelan and then Sylvia. And Nathan Brown out of side.
How valuable is Cameron Bruce? A bloke that can go and do a job like this on Johnson, can play in the middle, and can also go forward and kick their big bags of goals.
He doesn't look like he minds either, Gary, being given those sort of tasks.
No, he's got, he likes responsibility. He's got a massive engine. He's a super fit footballer. And he's got a, one of the best scalps in the game today.
Travis Johnston long. Oh, good mark in front, Robertson. Well done.
The Dogs just, while gets himself up and has a shot at this, the Dogs' style of game, does that now need to be, like, they've got plan A, got to go to plan B at some stage, the running of the footy today?
I think they've been accused of that in years gone by, Gary, and I think they've got more up their sleeve this year than they've ever had, surely. I mean, they were a one-style game in previous years to this, but I think this year they can alter, adjust.
Robertson, high ball. But it's a straight ball. Number 16 for the D's.
Well, they've got through this. This will be a victory without... Oh, two goals to Russell Robertson is okay, but he's done very little else. David Neitz has kicked three, so... But still been relatively quiet. So... There's some things to take out. This Pickett and off the ground very early on in the piece. So, just a little wink and a nod. Loves a go, Robbo.
39 point margin now in favour of the Demons. And of course, the Bulldogs in round two beat the Demons by 47 points. Let's not forget that. Back here now, though, with Farron Ray. Big ground out to the southern stand side. Boyd a chipping ball in, looking for Kearney, who was completely outmanoeuvred by Whelan.
How good this bloke's game been, Matthew Whelan. He's been rock solid.
Very good.
Ward and White so often receives the ball in this position. McDonald. What is offering downfield? Uzay getting himself in a good position downfield. Got three in the meantime. Advantage played. Uzay's got the sit. Couldn't get a run at it. Strong mark in front. Bait.
Umpire going over to talk to Jordan McMahon. That was the, what the whistle was you heard. But they decided to allow play to go on. And this is the result. Matthew Bait. They like him to go forward. Late for Jordan McMahon to get the... James McDonald now, he's got 30 possessions.
Four goals in his eight games. Bait never looked any big but a goal up one. And the Demons march on.
I've got a question for you, Gary.
Yes, please, Jim.
Can you win a flag without a key dominant big forward? Now, the Dogs don't look to have one. Adelaide, who are a much better credentialed side to have a crack at this final series, don't have one either.
Oh, well, Rusciutto, Henschel, Perry, all
yeah,
those
Perry's not playing, Henschel's not big.
When they get themselves up. Well, I think you need a dominant forward, a big dominant forward to get the business done in September.
Well, you look at the sides that have won it recently, they've all had one. Barry Hall, Tredray, Jonathan Brown, as Bruce takes a mark in the back half for the Demons.
Who's on this bloke, by the way?
Not sure. He's had his own sharing today.
And him.
And he has too. And Bartram's been very good. It's been a good display by the Demons. They've got two crucial injuries out of it, which all D's fans will have their breath held until they find out what's going on there, but that aside, it has been a very nice display from the Melbourne Footy Club. Rivers is a good player. Bait is emerging. McCormack with him. Went back and got it to Griffin. Nice hands on the up to West. West will get it back. He's had 27 possessions today. Another terrific performance from him. Minson has it fisted away by Rivers. And McDonald just continues to get the ball.
Career high for Daniel Ward. He's up to possession number 32. That's his highest ever. And Matthew Whelan has had 31. That's his highest ever possession tally. Not that they mean an enormous amount sometimes.
Bruce on the wing, just in front of where Chris Jones sits.
Well, they're down to one fit man on the bench. The D's, Nathan Brown's just come off with what looks to be a shin injury.
Let's hope that isn't of a major concern. Jeff White, a fit player there as Carroll across half back. Going to be a big win here for the Demons. They lead it by 45 points. Highest margin of the game. Down to the last minute. Carroll, so many good things happening with the way Melbourne are playing their footy at the moment. Bait. Melbourne next week play Carlton at the Telstra Dome. And the Western Bulldogs have got the Tigers here at the MCG. Bait. Delivery into the 50. Uze, and wouldn't this be fitting if he were to cap it off with his fifth goal? May even be after the siren if he uses his full allotment of 30 seconds.
Well, this has been a bit of a whitewash after quarter time.
25 disposals in his 250th game. Adam Uze lines up for goal number 5 and gets it. What a finish! Couldn't finish on a better note for Adam Uze.
That is the noise. That is the noise that you're hearing. Uze. What did you see there, Brian? You see a bit of love there.
Colin Sylvia was celebrating with his teammates and one of them punched him right in the eye. Accidentally, but nailed him right in the eye. Look, look at him in the screen there.
This win comes at a cost, a substantial cost, but I'm pretty sure the New York Enemy won't be dwelling on that after the game. They will all have to put up a very brave front. He has got one there. That's a bit rough when you get through a game without copping one, without the Bulldogs putting a bruise on you, and then you go to the post-game celebration and you cop one. But the least of their worries, this is the problem, this is the story. Despite the victory for the Demons, the story is this. Byron Pickett off the ground the first or second quarter with a bad hamstring, and now Aaron Davey. That's the downside. The upside is that man, Adam Uze, has played 250 games. He's played a blinder with 5 goals. He's with Chris Jones.
Well, that is some way to celebrate your 250th, isn't it?
Yeah, no doubt. We really set ourselves for a big game today, and the Bulldogs have been playing really good footy, so, yeah, it's a great way to celebrate the 250 for a good win.
5 goals, it was almost 6. Tell us who the one that you celebrated a little earlier for.
Yeah, I think I'm going to cop a little bit for that. I just thought I was in and turned around. I don't know what happened. I think I was yelling out to someone in the crowd, so I didn't get to see exactly what happened, but I think I'm going to cop it.
You were lucky because you kicked a freak from the same spot later on.
Yeah, I need to make up for it. So, no, obviously, I'm really happy to get a win in the 250th. And for Nathan Jones, in his first game, he played really well as well. So, yeah, all good.
I suppose the one bad part of the day, a couple of injury concerns.
Yeah, I think Byron, I'm not too sure what he's done, but yeah, it looks like he might be out for a week or two, and I don't know who else.
Aaron Davey went off at the end too, Hammy as well, I think.
Yeah, hopefully it's just cramp for Flash. He was awesome today, so yeah, we've got a little 6-day turnaround coming up, and we've got, I think, we've got the Blues next week, so it's a big game.
Well, congratulations, I know the fans loved it.
Thanks, mate.
Yes, indeed, Jonesy, they did. He always puts on a show, does Adam Uze.
Didn't look like cramp to me, Gary. That's a big ice pack on Aaron Davey. And
no cramp.
Young man who will remember his first game forever, I'm sure anyone who plays their first league game remembers it, but especially when it's a big celebration game for a club superstar and it ends up being a 51-point win.
A smile there from Neil Danaher, so maybe not all as bad as what is first presumed with Aaron Davey. But the first gamer that Jim Brayshaw jumped on very early in the piece, Nathan Jones, is with Chris Jones.
Well, Nathan, congratulations. JB claimed him as your man, that you were his man earlier in the day. How was it playing your first game?
Best feeling, most unbelievable thing ever. I played on here in the TAC Cup Grand Final last year. It's the first game I ever played here, and this beats it by a long way.
If you come in and play in Adam Uze's 250th and a big crowd, and you played really well yourself too.
Yeah, Uze is a great player. Got him back from Melbourne before I came here, but mate, he's one of the best blokes and deserves everything he's got. So,
did you feel comfortable out there today? You definitely looked it.
I was just keen to get a touch, and then once I got a couple, I just came. He got used to the speed, so no, it was all right. It was good.
All right, congratulations. Well done, mate.
Thanks, mate.
Yeah, when they go recruiting players these days, boys, they look at the talent, obviously. They've got to be able to mark it and kick it and run and all those things, but they go for character as much as anything. And a very strong character, that young man, Nathan Jones. And good character.
Come into the game bald, Brian.
Yes.
His first game as an 18-year-old, he's got no hair.
Man, that's obvious.
Fantastic.
The difference between him and a couple of others that have gone down that path, I think he could get a shag going if he wanted to, Jim.
Yes, I
think. Nice to have that up your sleeve.
Oh, he's heading off. He's forgotten. Oh, no, he's going to see the support.
He's going to see mum and dad. Oh, Brian, don't begrudge him that.
Adam Uze, look at this. Brock McLean and Colin Sylvia.
Getting cheered off by the future of this Melbourne Football Club. Talking of characters, good two very good young men. Brock McLean. Oh, he's a very solid unit. They're going to be around for a while, those boys. And Peter Curran there, assistant coach. Adam Uze leads them down the road. So they're going to be a fairly rousing rendition. Nice touch with the young first gamer too.
Bringing a tear to Gary's eye, seeing the chef boy at 250, Brian.
It is. He's quite watered up about it.
Yes, it's fantastic to see.
Ah, chuffed. I am chuffed for him. He's a good lad. He's a very good lad. And as I said many times throughout the call, just so talented.
I looked at the six players that have played 250 for Melbourne, Brian. I didn't see Gary's name. What happened to you?
No, I'm not in that class, Jim.
Yes, that's frightening. Because you had 230 up when you were about 24.
Thank you, Jim. You fool.
What happened at the end there, Gary?
Dried up a bit on him.
Shut up, you too. Just stay with this and concentrate on this victory, if you wouldn't mind. I reckon the Dogs are really disappointing today. That's the other side of the coin. We'll talk about them after the break, after we hear the Melbourne theme song. Just the one goal, I think, Brock McLean is saying. But I thought they were disappointing, Brian.
Well, they were, and I reckon it's the first time this year that I've seen them live where they have not been in the hunt, Gary. They were completely out-hustled. The defensive skills that Melbourne showed today were extraordinary, and they were even more on that side of their game because they knew that that was a particular part of their game that could beat the Bulldog style that they deliver week in and week out.
That's the blueprint, I think, you've got to take in for games against the Dogs. Hopefully we can get Chris Jones down there to find out exactly what the injury situation is with Byron Pickett and Aaron Davey. But in the meantime, tight circle the Demons have. No one gets in the middle except the first gamer. And maybe the old bloke. No, he'll stay out at a Muzo. And the first time he sang the Melbourne theme song, Brian.
And he'll get a wedding too.
Just a bit of dousing on the way through.
And that cordial gets sticky, Gary.
Stings the eyeballs too, Brian.